Hello, this is Kevin with Bangard Inc. And today's session is going to look at adding calculation columns to a report. There's many reasons that people need to do calculations. Some of them can be just to figure out like open remaining. So for example, AP, you might have a invoice amount and what's been paid and you want to see the open amounts, or maybe you've got like a project where you've got an estimate that you want to subtract job to date costs from to figure out how much estimate dollars are remaining. Some of those type of things. They could also be situations where maybe you want to join fields together. So in this example, I'm going to go back into the report that we created in a prior video. Going to bring it up, edit here. We had one column for job, name, vendor, vendor name, our invoice number, date, so on and so forth. Invoice amount of pay. One column I might want is the open amount. If I click up on this button here, this stands for calculation column, that would let me add my own calculation to the report. A folder title is basically just something that you can go back and find these by later for grouping. If you had different types of custom formulas that you're building that you want to keep grouped together, you could do those type of things. In my case, I'm just going to call them custom at the moment. And then for my title, I'm just going to say open amount. And we're going to keep it pretty simple. So we're just going to say take my invoice amount. And subtract my paid amount. And there's my open amount column. With those calculations, you can get into doing if statements, rounding statements, all sorts of different logic like you would in Excel and other places that you write formulas. The next one I want to take a look at is I want to merge job and job description together into one. In this case, I'm going to go up to define. And I'll see all my different columns there. So you'll see under that custom where I kind of told it what that folder was going to be. I saw the open amount for the one I just created that way. Another way of creating columns is you can actually pick any field. So I'm just going to pick that one because it's the first one in the list. There's that AP 1099 detail. If I look at the edit formula for that line, it has something in it. This is where I can go back and actually build other things from that. So as I take a look here, I should be able to find my job. And my job name. So what I want to do here is I want to build a column where I'm going to join the job ID, and the job name together into one cell. To do that, you do kind of a merge symbol, or in other SQL and things like that, they call it a concatenate, but it's a way of joining different texts together. So in Report Writer here, that's basically done with, I believe they call it a pipe symbol. It's the key right above the enter key, using your shift to get to it, and it's basically two lines by each other, stands for, you know, joining two text things together. And then I'm going to tell it what I want to join. So just like SQL, text is encapsulated in single tick marks, which is the key to the left of your inner key, just a single one instead of the double quotes, like other report places you might be used. And I'm just going to separate it with just some dashes. And then I'm going to put a couple more of the pipe symbols in there for my joining. And then if you don't remember, here is also the button down there for, you know, they call it concatenate there. So the syntax is a little different than some other places, but that's kind of a reminder of what I use when I, you know, put that together. And if I said okay to accept it, now you notice it says job being joined with my job name. If I go back to my refine, there's my new column where I've joined those two together. I might make that my lead column now. And in my case, I might second guess myself and decide I might want a space in there too. I don't like how tight those are together for some reason. So I'm going to come back into here from a refine. I'm going to go back and find that field again. And let's go back to the edit formula. And I might just come back in within my tick marks and just add a couple little spaces there. And I want to do the same thing with my vendor ID and vendor name. There again, I'm going to just pick any field. Doesn't really matter. 1099 was the top of the list, so that's what I used again. I'm going to say edit formula, knock out whatever it had, and go back and find my, what did I just say? Vendor ID. Let's put that in there. And let's say that I want to concatenate that with space dash dash space. My quote mark there, another concatenate in there. And behind that, let's say we're going to put the name. You do have to hit this little greater than symbol there to drop the field in. That looks good. If we go back to our refine so we can preview that. There's the new column for that one. And I might move it right next to it. So job, vendor, with both the vendor ID and names and job numbers and names all together. So these columns I may not need anymore. So this is a way that sometimes you can kind of consolidate how much width you show on reports by putting multiple things together. So, you know, one place I used this just not too long ago is I was working on a report where we needed to put in the address, city, state, zip, all in one column for a spreadsheet export that we're doing. So we were able to go in there, create a formula, use that concatenate function to put the address together with the city together. And that way, when it's exported to Excel, it keeps it all into one column instead of letting them look like different columns. And let's go back in then, and I think we'll take a look at column properties a little bit here also. As I look at this, there's a few things that I want to refine. So theoretically, now that I've got this field here for my job name and that put together and my vendor name put together, I really don't need these first few columns. So I can actually just take them out of the report at the moment. So I'm just going to come back in here and delete those. So now if I come back and refine it, I should see about the same information, just a little bit cleaner. So job and description together, vendor and vendor name together, and then the same information as I had prior then. So the other thing I don't like about these are some of my different column headings. So it's kind of showing the concatenate and what I put together there that probably isn't what I want to see on my report at the moment. So I'm going to go back into my define. I'm going to take a look at that column, and I'm going to look at the column properties a little bit here. This lets you control some fonts and the size of fonts and things like that. So that way, if you want to pop that as a heading and make it a little bit bigger or different font and things like that, you can. What I'm going to focus on here at the moment is the format. So right now it's got this in for the title that I don't like. I'm going to say that I want a custom heading and I'm going to make that go away. And I'm just going to say job. And okay. And I'm going to come back over to this and I'm going to do the same concept with this one. So that's going to be a custom. And maybe I'm just going to say vendor. And I don't really like that bill number, so I might even change it to, and maybe in my case, I'd rather call it a invoice number. And you get the basic idea, so that way I can kind of go through there and just change these columns up to what I want. So maybe I don't like base amount either. I'm going to call that an invoice amount. And as I refine that and look at that, then should be getting a little bit cleaner. So that way I see job, vendor, invoice number, my date, my invoice amount. So I could start to see that I've kind of there again, getting the report a little bit more into what I want, because I'm basically doing some custom calculations to put, you know, I had to calculate this open amount. I want to join these things together. I want these particular column headings to be called that particular way. Getting the report that much closer to what I need this thing to look like. And that concludes this session. Thanks for watching.